What's going on, everybody? Welcome to my playthrough of Alan Wake. I always wanted to play Alan Wake. It came out back in 2010. It was a thriller that was exclusive, a thriller game that was exclusive to the Xbox 360. It looks pretty interesting. It looks like a Stephen King type of mystery thriller slash horror. Well, can't wait to jump into it. Let's see. This icon there's game saving. Got it. Now I'll be doing definitely a new game. Oh, there's normal, hard, nightmare. Move the slider to adjust brightness. Of your screen, only the text and the two lower boxes should be visible. Okay. Barely visible. Or the game won't be dark enough and it won't be scary enough.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of
logic.
Stephen
and there's King.
Fun to be had in explanations.
I should put subtitles on.
The poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
And I would love this, the fundo Stephen King's balls for creating some of the best horror stories ever made. It would be my pleasure.
Imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
Damn, dude, you must have... You're blind as a bat.
I'd seen the hitchhiker too late.
The hell were you looking at? What were you jerking off to fucking the Christine novel?
I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
I had to throw this guy on the side of the road.
Suddenly, his body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Best thing to do is just get back in the car and just go around all this, take a detour. Look up to the light, turn. R turns camera, okay. Ooh, it's a UFO. No. I hate inverted controls. Hell to walk. Really. Get back in the car. No, I'm not doing anything here. Nope. Damn, one dude caused all that damage. What a weak ass car.
The radiator had broken when I hit the hitchhiker. The car wasn't going anywhere.
The car is a piece of shit.
There was something important waiting for me there.
The hell are these books on the floor? What does that say? I can't read. Text is too small. Can you zoom in? Ah, oh, fuck it. I'll find out later. This light keeps following me. Get to the lighthouse. Now! the hell? What the hell?
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder?
No, I don't.
You think you're God?
Alan Wake.
You think you can just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill them when you think it adds to the drama?
Hey.
You're in this story.
Hey, man. Where do I go?
You'll never publish another one of your shitty stories. Hassan, gonna kill you.
It's not like your stories are any good. Not like they have any artistic merit. You're a lousy writer.
I'm just as good as Stephen King. Missing. Is that me?
Just look at me. Look at your work.
I create you? Dodge enemy attacks.
LB and L, that's weird.
You can't stop me.
Try again. Alright, good work. Successful dodge will sometimes highlight with cinematic moves.
The hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
Really? What the? Tired. I can't run anymore. Across it. I gotta stop. What the hell is it? It's the demon from Evil Dead. The fuck are you?
There's no way out.
It's dark, dude. What the hell is he watching? Solve the bullet. There's gotta be a way out. Come on, man. Get me out of here. I'm about to shit myself. What the hell? I'm taking damage.
Follow the light.
The light. Safe heaven. Haven.
Well, Billy Hill. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand? No. Follow my light.
Is it God?
I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The Hitchhiker has been taken over by the Dark Presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
LT to boost. Okay.
You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside. Control it. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy.
Insert battery.
Here, take the gun. Pick up the revolver.
I would also like a box of Captain Crunch. Hey, how about a Playboy bunny?
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Achievement earned. Can't read the shit.
This way, and now I'm gonna get him.
Hi, demon. Oh, hell no. Fuse box. No, it's just flare guns. What the hell I need this shit? I use that flare gun, so we have there. He fell off. What an idiot. Fuck out of here. Oh, guitar. Still behind.
Shit.
in the lighthouse.
Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
It's all a dream, nice.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Bright Falls. It's not Maine. Just like in every other Stephen King movie. Wonder if that town's real, Bright Falls.
Stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you in the town in the background.
Why the fuck would I want to stand next to that guy?
I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy. Moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear
more
that
about Beerfest?
You have a lovely wife, if you don't mind me saying.
Yes, I do mind. I'm gonna throw you over this fucking rail.
I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an interview?
Look, Mr. Maine, I'm on vacation. In fact,
Mr. Maine,
I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Yeah, I'm posing.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Oh, I've got a real car in here. I mean, real make and model.
That's my favorite writer. Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry. We're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry. We're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay?
Damn.
Okay. Yuppies. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Okay. Let's hot wire this Lincoln right here. Wait a minute, I thought that brown car was ours. That's weird.
I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Odeer Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
He's taking a giant shit.
I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Carl Stuckey.
Try the coffee. Fuck? Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have.
Why is this thing
Rusty
blocking?
Here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
I'm not going to go look for a guy in the bathroom.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now.
What?
Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs...
Just shit your pants, huh?
To sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again?
No problem, man.
You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack.
Okay, I can practice some combat here. Punch the shit out of it.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Okay, look for this guy in the shit. Shitter.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
What the heck?
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
He's in the women's bathroom. Peeping in the stalls.
Hello?
I shouldn't have ate that Mr. Taco Stuckey. Supreme.
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Leave the diner.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fun.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you alright?
Splendid, splendid! Damn, aren't you? It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah, splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see you.
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
The hell?
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
No way.
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home, okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on KBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years.
I got writer's block, just like every other Stephen King character.
And now the weather. It's gonna be
lead character, I guess.
Wow, it's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right.
Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had it. Phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
This game should be easy. Just stay in the light, right? Avoid the dark. Just like Gears of War. See? So when we get eaten by Krill. Grill!
Come on.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
How about I flick the fucking light switch? How about that? I see something out here.
The Deerfest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. Famous artist, no less.
Wouldn't be out there. Power box, circuit box.
Why, hello, Rose.
Got the basement.
Cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
Got the basement.
Cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier. For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Ah! The hell?
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
The old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Let there be light.
Been the site for a love story. It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work.
Forget that I need to pay bills.
I thought we could be happy here.
Live off the land.
Alice? Honey?
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
All right. You better be in that new lingerie I bought. Hell yeah.
Hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
A typewriter.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
Didn't I tell your ass not to bring this shit?
I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past.
Damn, Alice!
I'm gonna slap her.
Everyone
Hey! Just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that! That's not...
Oh, shit.
Alan?
Looks like I gotta go back outside.
Alan?
Wait, don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it! I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Masturbate. Maybe it might help.
Damn it. Alice?
Oh, shit.
Alice? Had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice, I'm coming!
Oh, shit.
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot. Station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Let's see, not really. What's over here?
Damn.
Wonder if my car insurance will cover that. They have Allstate insurance.
Hello?
Someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Definitely not writing that. I should have brought my pebbles. I think I'm lost. Yeah, it's where the car fell off. Ah, oh, man. What about down there? Oh, shit.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident. Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
cabins for rent in...
Oh, shit.
Hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Come on, man. No guns or light. What happened? Do I kill him? Oh, no, I can't. That's where I started. There we go. Oop.
Drive.
of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
It's Johnny!
During your trying, it's the latest.
Yes.
Woman.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station. Call me up.
Hello? Hello?
You can see the sight.
Energizer. They keep going. Oh hell, this guy's a bulldozer. Right out of here. Look at the house. Damn. Oh, got shot.
There were more of them.
Dead. Yeah, I thought I had the light on.
There were more of them.
Loose light.
Outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone or something. There were no bodies, they just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
It's rabbit season!
Dark spirits die. Going in a fucking circle. There we go.
What the hell was that? When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Just a secret.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Float like a butterfly.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Great.
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Follow the line. Nope. Cable.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
You shut up. Right there. Guess that's what you do. Find a way on top of this. Here we go. Ha! I fell off. How do I fall? Is there a jump? Peter Totters. Okay, there's a jump. I forgot there's a jump. Oh! What's in here?
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't.
We go shotgun. No, a flare gun.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the state. Belly Burster is the best with no coat. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
the axe. I don't want to. Oh. Where? I see you now. Service. Shit, I'm running out of batteries. Okay, you can let the battery recharge. I didn't know that. Other dude. I fell off the cliff. Gotta get over there.
This flare. Graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Oh no. Man. What the fuck was that? I didn't have the flare gun equipped. What's that creepy noise? Thank you. pretty scary. Reminds me of Silent Hill 2. This is the cherry picker out there. What's that? Probably that thing. I think if you shoot this, big explosion. Oh, okay. Oh boy. Do anything, huh? Get that thing open. I took a real darkness.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reached the lights at the gas station alive. I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right. I'll keep waiting. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Wiper Pro. Use the phone.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Candy-colored clown, they call the Sandman.
The fuck is her song?
Tiptoes to my room every night. And just a sprinkle.
What the hell is this?
Go to sleep, everything is alright. I close my eyes, then I drift away into. I softly say a silent prayer.
Skip.
Previously on Alan Wake, I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at, but the cabin had disappeared.
Oh, New York City 3 years ago. You can pause these cutscenes.
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Where's the coffee pot? It's the blender. Here we go.
Coffee's
achievement unlocked. Holy shit. Read much? Fuck. It's like a little library in here.
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk.
Another coffee.
Tell me what you think.
Thermos.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Oh, really?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up.
Conveniently close. Yeah.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
So that won't help.
Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you, too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wake, how are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Thank you for testing the lights, Miss Weaver. Everything seems to be fine.
I don't have the luxury of being complacent, Deputy Grant. The bulbs will need changing soon. You can't change them in the dark.
I'll be sure to take care of it, Miss Weaver. Have a nice day now.
Very good. I'll come back later on to remind you, just in case.
Yeah, it's Mulligan here. I'm at Stuckey's gas station with Thornton.
There's no sign of him, or...
Wait. Yeah, this is Thornton. Look, we've located the parade float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stucky was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsal today. Over.
Oh, give me that. Mulligan here. Looks like someone really thrashed the garage. Over.
Okay, roger that, guys.
Mr. Wake? The sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor?
Really?
That was Cynthia Weaver. I guess you can call her the town eccentric. She used to be the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused
on Richard Bogg, Bruce Dansky, Jacob Miller. I bet those are the developers. Very funny. Gonna put our faces on the missing poster.
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now. Your phone, Mr. Wake?
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember.
Oh, fuck.